quickly as you like. Good evening, good evening. Can you see me? Oh, what issues I have had tonight. What can I tell you? So it is a bit late. In fact, it's 9:08 according to my clock. Yes. Good evening, chat. Refresh for video, says Sav. Although if you need to refresh, you can't see me. And in fact, you can't hear me. So those of you who can see me and hear me, just say refresh for video. Thank you very much. This is a public information film. I can see Sav on my laptop screen going, ah. It has been a bit tense for the last 40 minutes. We are here. Dare the Rayon says, Harry Potter and the Deathly Battles, what's all that about? Shocking. Yes, anyway, there you go. We are now live. It is me, Marco Van B, otherwise known as Mark Green, and it is Vaper Scene. I've got some news stories for you. I have a little bit of ET about the Atom, which you saw some time ago on Dave's birthday show, but he was ginned up, so I've done another one. Yeah, and I took it with me to Scotland at the weekend for I Was There. You'll see that in the VT, which is coming up in part two. And then we've got another little bit of VT that was on, would have been on last week's show, but I moved it to this week's show and I've edited it down. Which is not actually e-cig related whatsoever. I just thought it might be of interest. Yes. Anyway, all that hopefully is going to be after what we like to call the titles. Smashing.
Vaper Scene is proudly sponsored by Health
Eva. Bye
bye. UK purveyor of e-cigarettes and Pure Perfection e-liquids.
Yes, it's me, and apparently you could hear my audio over the titles. What's all that about? I don't know what's going on with this computer tonight. I really don't. Did I swear? I might have done. anyway, there we go. We are here. We are certainly live. And it is Tuesday the 28th of July 2015. Who's in chat? That was a long video, says Paul Robinson. It wasn't that long. Titles, not that long. Yes, who have we got in chat today? Fuzzy and Ashley and Brian and Kizzy and Spiritus and Mike B and DJ Reptile and Martin and Paul and Robin and Monster and Rob and Max. And who else we got? Ridian and Mr. Dibley's in the house and Bernice and Costello and me. But I'm not logged in, so you don't know it's me, but it is in fact me. Yes. And Leanna Lawless, yes. And if I've missed you out, you're in there. I can't read you all out. So, yes. It's been a bit of a strange day today, well, at least the last hour has, anyway. But we are here, and we're going to get through this, even if it kills me, which I hope it doesn't, but there you go. I've got some news stories and stuff, and I'm just going to change my little display so I can see what's going on. There we go. I see what's going on up here, you see, and I see what is going on down here, and some bits over here, and chat down there. And it's confusing at times, but it's all good. We've got some news stories, yeah. And we're going to go with the very famous Daily Fail on the first one. There we go. Pupils prefer e-cigs to real things. More than 1 in 5 admit to trying vaping in the past year compared to 18% who smoked. First of all, good, better than smoking. Now back to the story. 22% of 11 to 15 year olds, years olds, bad grammar, said they have tried e-cigarettes once. Number admitting to smoking has fallen to its lowest level since 1982. Health and Social Care Information Centre quizzed 6,173 pupils and fears that e-cigarettes could lead to smoking appear unfounded. That is the only good bit. Oh, you got that shot then? Yeah, hello, got that shot. Hit the wrong button. Yes, that's the only good bit about it, really. Let's go back. More school children have tried e-cigarettes than smoke, according to official figures. The number of children aged 11 to 15 smoke tobacco is the fondest level ever recorded, according to the figures. And 18% of pupils admitted to smoking in 2014, the Health and Social Care Information Centre reported. And it goes on. It was the lowest level since the annual survey began in 1982 and continues the decline since 2003, when 42% of pupils had tried it. Maybe they'll want to spend their money on something other than 10 quid a pack fags. I don't know. Let's go back. But very few went on to carry on the vaping habit regularly. Just 1% of those questioned used an e-cigarette device at least once a week. The figures based on a survey of 6,173 pupils in 210 schools suggested that 3% smoked tobacco once a week, and the HSCIC said the figures indicated that around 90,000 pupils aged 11 to 15 were regular smokers. The guys have got the link to that story in chat for you. I won't go through the rest of the pages because it does go on a little bit. But pop up in chat and tell me what you think of that. Do you think it's a good thing that children are not smoking? Or a bad thing that they are trying e-cigarettes instead of smoking? And it's positively evidence now that people, young children, young adults, school children, whatever, trying vaping, don't then go on and buy a packet of fags, which is what everyone keeps telling us is going to happen. If a young person, an adolescent, whatever age, tries an e-cigarette, like, you know, nice and fruity, or bubble gum, or candy floss, or what have you, is then going to go and want to buy a pack of normal cigarettes. It's just not happening, is it? Bernie 7 says, brilliant that they are not smoking. Fuzzy Ann says she's having problems with her eyesight. Dave the Rion, kids will experiment better e-cigs than lit tobacco. Totally agree. Gary Dibley says, first impression is wow. Smoking youngster numbers are reducing, says Bernice as well. And they are. This is the thing. They are reducing. It's a case of why. Do we need to know why they are reducing? Or should we just be happy that they are reducing? What we don't want is obviously kids using e-cigs because they're not supposed to, but I'd rather they use an e-cig than lit a cig. That's what I think. Chief Keith said it's better than smoking, definitely, but the newspapers are sure to twist it into a negative story, and so far it's so bad the kids are now trying evil e-cigs. Yes. Spiritus says, I think it's amazing. Instead of trying a couple of fags and then smoking for life, they try an e-cig and think, meh, and don't bother again. Yeah, and that's good. If they try vaping and don't like it and think, well, if smoking's as bad, then I'm not going to do that either, then all the good, don't you think? It's weird. Leanna Lawless, I noticed cigs in a pack are reducing by TPD. No packs are 20. 18 or less. Now, that's strange, actually. Yeah, because I was visiting somebody at the weekend and they said it was 19 in the pack now for your 10 quid. So it costs you more and you get less. A bit like organic food, really, isn't it? Kizzy says, vaping and snogging in a bike shed. God, the kids have made it these days. Did it mention anything about snogging in the bike sheds, Kizzy, or is that just wishful thinking? I don't know. We didn't have bike sheds. No, we all walked to school. Anyway, Bernie says, parents are not smoking, plus more education in school. Yeah, that's a good point. There is lots more going on to try and stop people from starting to smoke, because it's a slippery slope, isn't it, once you start. We've all been there. And those of us who switch to vaping just enjoy the fact that, you know, we can use our vaping products, even if we do reduce our nicotine right down to zero. It's still nice. And Spiritus says, it does worry me a bit about the long-term future of my business if there are no new vapors, but I love people that are not smoking. Yes, that's the other thing, of course. You know, you've got people who earn their living from these devices, be that selling them, making them, wholesaling them, what have you. And without new vapors, then it's a pretty finite time, isn't it? Which is why, obviously, the tobacco companies want children to smoke, want people to start smoking younger, because we're living longer, which means they've got maybe 50, 60, 70 years of somebody smoking, which is good for the share price, isn't it? That's my opinion, of course. Not maybe the opinion of VebTrails TV, but it's my opinion. Anyway, let's go on to our next story. Oh, yes. Now, have you seen one of these? Now, this might disappear. No, it hasn't disappeared because it's yellow, not green. This is an EE power bar. Yes, now I'm with EE. And this is what EE customers can get hold of for free. And it is, it might disappear now because it's green. It is a battery. Come out. There you go. Oh, no, it hasn't disappeared. Oh, yes, it does. Disappears a bit because it's green. Yes, it's a power battery. A little power pack that you charge up and then you can charge your phone. And you can get them for free. And if it's dead, you can go to an EE shop and you can replace it with another one, or you can charge it up yourself. And the only stipulation is that every 18 months or so, you have to take it back and exchange it. It belongs to EE, doesn't belong to you. It belongs to EE, and it's kind of a free lease, so to speak. But according to this newspaper, The Independent, today, an EE power bar exploded and left serious burns after charger explodes like a firework. Yes. A medical student has been left with serious burns after an EE power bar exploded and set fire in her bedroom. Katie Emsley, 26, was asleep in her bedroom in Aberdeen when the power bar blew up in the early hours of Friday morning, narrowly missing her head. She was terrified after she was woken by a loud bang in the middle of the night after the phone charger plugged into her laptop to recharge shot out like a firework and blew across the room. The next thing she remembers was seeing flames underneath her bed. Yes. So it's not just e-cigarettes that explode, it's batteries too that aren't even related to e-cigarettes. Yes, very similar technology, of course. And I'm wondering whether it's an 18650 in there, to be fair. I'd love to take it apart, but it doesn't belong to me, so I can't really. It does go on. The student's mother, alerted by her screams, grabbed a damp towel and managed to put out the flames. My hands smelt of firework, my clothes smelt of firework, my hair smelt of firework, my pillow was black soot on it, so it obviously went past my pillow and missed my head by about 6 inches. It could have landed on my bed and I might not even be here. Yes, now I think this is where a little bit of common sense kind of comes into being. I don't charge anything in the bedroom. That's just my preference. In case anything does happen, I've got smoke alarms in all my rooms in the house. They're all linked and they all go off, and it's really, really loud if it goes off. But some people don't have smoke alarms, and you kind of want to trust the device that you've got. But there's so many devices out there with batteries, Was it the lead? I mean, it comes with a lead. Let me just get it out again. It comes with its own lead, which is yellow. So was it that lead that was being used, or was it another lead? Was it the wrong lead? Did the laptop USB socket overcharge it, or was it faulty? And because these get given to different people and then handed back in again, you don't know if it's been thrown around or damaged or got water in it or whatever. So it's kind of less confident. I have to say, when I've used this, and I've used it a couple of times, it has got rather warm. Yeah. So I'm going to continue to use it, but I'm not going to charge it anywhere where it could possibly cause any issues, really. Let's see what chat I've got to say. Spirita says everyone should have smoke alarms. Yes, should. Smoke alarms are so cheap, and you know, they'll definitely better save your life than not having one at all. Leanna's got a very loud flashing smoke alarm. I kid you not, I shall record my smoke alarm going off. It's a fire alarm system I've got in my house, because it's a four-story house, so you have to have fire alarms in them now. And when it goes off, my goodness, it would definitely wake me up, because there's a sounder on the first floor and a sounder downstairs, and it's really loud. I'll record it, send it out to you. Spiritus says again, my bet is a faulty power regulator chip or whatever it's called. Yes, possibly. Rob says in another article, the medical student claimed that she had to have her hand under cold water for 3 hours before it had cooled down enough to be treated. I really hope she doesn't qualify. Well, yeah, I don't know how hot it got, but an hour generally, making noise here, an hour generally is enough to cool down a reasonable burn. 20 minutes is usually what's all is needed. Leanna Lloyd says smoke alarms as cheap as chips, and you need one for chip pan fires. Yeah, the old chip pan fire. It was plagued in the 70s and the early 80s with chip pan fires, and then people started to get the deep fat fryers that had thermostats instead of leaving it on an open flame, going out to the pub and leaving your 8-year-old kids making chips with sharp knives. Yes. What else have we got? Bernice says, does it come with instructions? I thought USB 3 was a no-no. Actually, well, let's look in the box. Does it come with any instructions at all? Yes, it does. There we go. It does come with instructions. And I've not read them. And it tells you, don't get it wet. Don't take it apart. Don't expose it to extreme temperatures. Don't throw it away. Plug the micro USB end of your cable into the power bar, then plug the other end into a 5-volt adapter or your computer. That's what it says. It doesn't tell you what amperage it needs to be. It just says that it needs to be 5 volts, and the output is 1 amp maximum. But it doesn't tell you what the input is, just that it takes 5 volts. So maybe that needs addressing. Yeah. What else have they got to tell me in chat? Let me just scroll down. It's going too quick. Miles said there was 2 sub-ohmers in one room over the weekend and his alarms went off. That was in your hotel, Miles. Down on the south coast. And Fuzzy Ann says, if you don't have a smoke alarm, how do you know when dinner's ready? Well, ask Gary Dibley that. Because Gary likes burnt food, don't you, Gary? and Leanna says, glad my mate switched from pipe to vaping. Used to set the alarm off. I've got to say, I've not set my alarm off at home once. And, you know, I'm blowing plumes generally towards it. It's one of the optical ones, and it doesn't tend to go off. No. So there you go. That was that little story. Let's have another one before we have the first ads. And this is on They Work For You. And I've shown you They Work For You on other shows. And if you go on there and register, you can follow your MPs. And I have email alerts for the Parliamentary Undersecretary of State for Health, Jane Ellison, and also my MP. So anything that, she's involved with or my MP is involved with, I get emails. And that's the wrong slide for you. That was the first one, yes. So Luciana Berger, or Berger, asked what estimates has he made of the cost of to the NHS of treating smoke-related diseases in each of the last 3 years? And the answer there from Jane Ellison was that the department does not maintain an annual record of the cost. Why not? Why aren't they maintaining costs? How much things cost? Surely that's how budgets work, isn't it? You know how much you've been spending, so you know how much you need to get for the next year. And she goes on to say, however, in 2015, Action on Smoking and Health, in its publication Smoking Still Kills, estimated that the total cost of smoking to society in England alone is approximately £13.8 billion a year. This figure includes a £2 billion deficit, direct cost to the NHS of treating smoking-related diseases. So that's not fact, that's an estimation by Ash. It's an estimation by Ash, not fact. There was another one as well, which was this one. This appeared today. Philip Davis, Conservative in Shipley, asked the Secretary of State for Health, pursuant to the answer of 13th July 2015 to question 5566, if you will place in the library a copy of the assessment undertaken in the awarding of all grants to Action on Smoking and Health by his department, and what the job title is of the official responsible for making recommendations to ministers on awarding such grants. And there was another kind of worded question as well. And this is the reply. Jane Ellison again. The assessments undertaken in awarding of grants to Action on Smoking and Health contain policy advice to ministers and so are not made public. The Deputy Director, Tobacco Control and Responsibility Deal, was the official responsible for making recommendations to ministers on the awarding of such grants. And the department reached its conclusion that ASH was the only charity in this area with the appropriate national reach and focus and appropriate standing in international arena based on assessment of the information contained in the grant application and other relevant information. So basically, she won't say because it contained advice to ministers. And I'm pretty sure that there's been another bit from that in relation to a Freedom of Information Act requests about where the funding comes from. But basically, ASH are the only people that get any funding. Yeah. I'll leave you with that thought, and I'll have a look at chat during the ads. Yes, I'll see you in two.
Vaper Scene is proudly sponsored by Health eVape, UK purveyor of e-cigarettes and Pure Perfection e-liquids.
Often imitated, never duplicated. Award-winning service and products from cloud9vaping.co.uk.
And now it's back to Vapor Scene on Vapor Trails TV. Vapor Scene is sponsored by Healthy Vape, UK purveyor of e-cigarettes and Pure Perfection e-liquids.
And we're back in the room. Hello. I muted my microphone during the adverts just in case. So I've unmuted myself again. Yes, welcome back to part two. I was just looking at chat there during the ads. Symphony Vapors has asked, how much revenue do the government get from the sale of cigarettes? Well, I'll tell you what to do, Symphony. This is what you should do. You should raise a Freedom of Information Act request to the Secretary of State for Health, maybe even via your MP, but I don't think you need to go via your MP to raise such a request, and ask that question. And as far as I'm aware, they have to reply within 40 days, and they have to reply to a Freedom of Information Act request. What you might get back is that much paperwork, with that much you can actually read and the rest redacted, which is quite possible, but they still have to respond. So if you do that, let us know and tell us what comes back. Yes. And Leanna Rula says 90% of the cost. Yeah, well, possibly, but we don't know if there's any kind of levies either going on, do we, like in California. I'm not exactly sure how much comes in other ways apart from just in duty. But then, you know, most of what we buy is either dutied up or vatted up. So most of it goes to the government anyway, doesn't it, in one shape or another. Having just got my payslip today, I can see how much I've paid the government in taxes. Yes. Yeah, Blaze says maybe ask HMRC. Yeah. That'll be from the customs point of view. So HMRC would be a good point of call. If someone does that, let us know. You know what to do. Vaper Scene at vaporchores.tv. Yeah. Let's go back to that shot. There we go. Email address is off. So, I had a bit of a strange weekend because I was going to be doing some stuff, but things changed a little bit because I had to go to Scotland at the weekend. So, I was going to do something on this, on Sunday, which is the Atom Viper that Dave Dawn had on the Haze Hour some time ago, and I had the Blaze, which was the little brother of this, but I picked one up at Vapor Expo, and I did a bit of VT on Saturday and then followed it up on Sunday on my journey home. So here is part one, all the closey uppy type stuff. Yes, see you in a minute. You may remember a few weeks ago I showed you the Blaze from Atom, which was the little brother of the Viper from Atom. And I showed you the Blaze, and Dave Dawn gave you a little glimpse of the Viper on his birthday show. Yes. So I picked one of these up. I picked the Viper up at Vapor Expo. So what I thought I'd do is show you a less gin-infused version of the Viper. So let's have a look at what you get. Yes. The packaging is very similar to the Blaze, which makes sense. It comes in a cardboard box, which is recycled cardboard. It comes with the little product catalogue little mini thing, a little cleaning cloth, some waterproof stick-on decals that you can wrap around your battery, should you so wish. And then the battery itself, plus the pre-built tank and a spare glass tank. And then underneath the plastic, if I can just get that out, underneath the plastic you have your USB charging cable, the instructions for the coil and also for the battery, and a spare coil. And the coils are the same as on the Blaze, and it's variable juice flow. So let's take this out and we'll have a little look. Very secure in there. There's a spare tank. It's the Venom tank on the Vaper device. And to change that, that's the atomizer head. Let me zoom in. That's the pre-installed atomizer head. And as you can see, if I just put that down for a second, move that out of the way, you can change the juice flow by rotating this part here at the bottom. It's better to have it on full juice, because then you're going to get the maximum juice onto your atomizer. And then if you've got it on full airflow, which is changed here, then you're going to get a much better vape, I should think. Changing the atomizer is easy enough. You just unscrew it. There you go. And it screws back in. And it's, as you can see, this is completely hollow. So that is what is connecting onto your battery, which is why this does not fit on a normal Ego battery. Yeah. Change the tank, you literally unscrew the two sections and the tank comes off. And then you can put the spare one on. If you crack it, I guess. I'll put it around the right way, Marco. Screw that back on, which is rather handy. I like that. I like the fact that it comes with a spare tank, just like the sub tanks do these days. So that's on there, nice and tight. Filling it, you fill from the bottom, as you would any other Ego style. So what we'll do is, we'll fill that. And what have I got this week? I've got some flavours. Fruits and berries. Peach smoothie strawberry. Yeah, or peach strawberry smoothie, if I say it right. There you go. It's a brand new bottle. I got this from Herman Vapes. Namba Juice. At e-cig Expo. This one is a 6 milligram, I think. I'm just looking. There we go. It's on the front. 6 milligram. Yeah. Let's give it a little bit of a smell. Oh, it smells nice. It smells nice, people. So we'll just fill the tank. You know how to do that. Missing the middle tube, which I haven't done, but there you go. Fill that to the level when it's just at. Yes. I wouldn't bother too much about priming the bottom, because that's going to prime and soak in while we talk about the other part of the kit. Other mentions, of course, it is a 510 drip tip. Now, have I got another 510 drip tip I can put on for you? Got this one. Yeah, that's fit. That's off the tornado tank. But a decent size drip tip there. So we'll leave that to soak in and we'll look at the battery. And we'll just put this juice over here. I'm in the unfortunate position of having to go to Scotland tomorrow. So I was going to be filming this tomorrow, but I'm filming it now. And then what we'll do is I'll talk to you in the car. And I'll be using it on the way, which is a 4.5 hour journey. So this is already charged, I must tell you. I've charged it already. Charges at the bottom, the USB port there. You have your little atom battery, and it's 5 click on, 5 click off. There we go. Now, interestingly, this top section comes off, so you can fit other devices on the top. And let me tell you, it will fire another device. And I'm going to grab a sub tank, one of my sub tanks. This is the one I was using last weekend, and it's currently got Wolfester in it, which is very nice. Let me just tell you what the resistance is by putting it on my Vapor Shark. And it's a 0.21 coil, according to the Vapor Shark. 0.21. So I'm going to put it on my device. And it does fire. You can hear that. and you can see it runs a sub tank quite nicely. It looks ridiculous, of course, but in an emergency it might be okay. Let me put the top a little bit back on and screw that back in. So it does run a sub tank quite nicely. It's obviously designed for this, so this shouldn't fit on a another device. So what we're going to do is get another device on the go. So here I've got an E-mount battery, and this has got the Nimbus tank on that I was using to test one of the juices that I made on Mixervape. And it's a normal Canthal coil. And as you see, it works. So, of course, this is a Ego style thread. So we're going to put the Venom tank on, and we'll see if this powers the Venom tank. And you'll see there, it's flashing away, telling me, go away, I'm not going to use you. So this does not work on other devices, let me tell you. But, as I've already shown with the sub tank, this battery will power other devices. And that's the Nimbus tank. So it's a one-way deal. Basically, it will power this, and it'll power other devices, but this doesn't work on anything else. So that is that's quite nifty, don't you think? So let's open up the throttle. There we go. Full airflow on there. We've already set the juice to full juice flow, and it's had plenty of time to soak in, so let's give it a blast. And you can see it does produce incredibly well. It is, I have to say, very loud. And you can hear it cracking away quite nicely. And there you go, yes. The juice is a bit different. You can definitely get strawberries from it, but I shall be vaping on this in the car tomorrow, and I'll give you more findings then, I think, because I really want to kind of take it through its paces, and hopefully it'll work quite nicely. So there you go. As for the moment, that's the Atom Vaper. It's a nice little unit. It's fairly long. I can't find my ruler, so what I've got is my Fat Max. Yes, other DIY measuring instruments are of course available, and you can see there it is 7 inches long, including the atomizer on top. Now, if we look at the Blaze. The Blaze comes in at just a tad under 7 inches. So we put them both together. You can see the difference there. Most of that being in the battery length. And just to see, we will see if these are interchangeable with each other. Because we've already ascertained this will not work on any other battery. But will it work on the Blaze battery? We shall see. Yes, it does. However, this battery is on its way out, power-wise, needs charging, so... But it does actually work, and we'll see... Any juice in there? Yes. We'll see if this tank works on the atom battery, which it does. And it performs reasonably well. It's the same atomizer inside, so I didn't have any inkling that it wouldn't work on the batteries. But what that proves is this works on these batteries. This works on these batteries. These batteries will power other things that are the same resistance, but not lower. But these will not work on any other devices, which is good. I like that. Then you can't use something that's far too low resistance on a battery and end up going pop. Now, I've got to tell you, before I head off to the car, this is an 1100 milliamp hour. It's pass-through, like the Blaze battery. It has the Snakebite sub-X ohm coils. And they're 0.5 ohms. And it also comes with a Snakebite mid-ohm coil at 1.2 ohms. That's the one you get spare. Obviously the Pyrex tank and the micro USB charger. Yeah. So it'll go down quite low. It obviously will go down to about 0.2. On the battery, given that the sub tank that I put on was a 0.21. So there you go. Yeah. We'll go to the car now, and then after the car, we'll go back to the studio. Yeah. See you in a while. And I know I said we're going to go to the car now, but we're not. We're going to go to the ads in a few seconds, and then we'll get the second part after the ads. Just looking through chat as that was rolling past. The juice flow. If you've got a higher PG juice, you might want to just close it off a little bit. It might flood. Or if you've got a heavier VG juice, you might want it all the way open, because then it'll wick right. To be fair, the juice I've got in there is go out of shot. Here it is. This is a 7030, I believe. 7030, and this is Applejacked, which is another flavours juice. Rather tasty, because the strawberry is in the car where I left it. Yes, so I filled it up again with some of that, and I've been vaping away on it during that, and it's got a tad warm now, and that's because I've been chaining it, really. But from a size point of view, from a performance point of view, you'll see more in the next bit of VT. But before that, we've got the ads, so I shall see you back here in about 2 minutes.
Vaper Scene is proudly sponsored by Health E-Vape, UK purveyor of e-cigarettes and Pure Perfection e-liquids.
Vapors, Dripper just got 40% bigger. So if you love discovering new e-liquids, tell Dripper what flavours you like and we'll send you 70ml of juice and at least 5 flavours. With a money-back guarantee and free delivery anywhere in Europe, dripper.co.uk.
What's in this e-cig cloud? Harmless water vapour, right? Pretty much, yes. Compared to a lit cigarette, it's much safer than smoke. But it contains nicotine. And nicotine on its own isn't toxic and doesn't cause cancer. If you're worried about switching to vapour, here are some facts. No tar, no smoke, no burnt tobacco. Cooking your evening meal produces more toxins than are found in exhaled vapour. Tobacco smoke contains toxins at very high levels, and vapour does not. And that vapour contains 6,000 times less carcinogens than cigarette smoke. Electronic cigarette vapour. There's nothing to be frightened of. The only dangerous electronic cigarette is a banned one.
And now it's back to Vapor Scene on Vapor Trails TV. Vapor Scene is sponsored by Healthy Vape, UK purveyor of e-cigarettes and Pure Perfection e-liquids.
Unmuted myself, and we're back for part three. just looking in chat there during the ads, and Angela S. Garnett says, "Are flavours made by bees?" No, honey is made by bees, and flavours is made by an e-juice company. And I got that particular juice and the strawberry one from Herman Vapes when I was at Vapor Expo. Good bunch of guys. You will hear some more about those in a moment, because we're going to go to the second part now, and this is the bit I did in the car. Yes. Enjoy.
Good morning. Hello. It's 10:05 on Sunday the 26th of July. Yes. And as I mentioned in my first bit of VT, I'm having to go to Scotland on a bit of an emergency dash. So I've been driving for a number of hours already. But I'm nearly there, yes. So what I thought I'd do is talk a bit more about the Vaper, which you've seen in the first bit of VT. As I mentioned, it's an 1100 milliamp hour battery, micro USB charging with pass-through, and it came with the Venom tank, which comes with a 0.5 ohm resistance atomizer and a 1.2 ohm resistance atomizer and a spare Pyrex tank. It's got a 2mm capacity, I think, 2mm capacity, and a wide bore tip, yes. So there you go. Five click on, five click off, just like an Ego battery. However, the actual tank doesn't fit on a normal Ego battery, only fits on the Atom batteries. However, the Atom battery will power something else, like an Ego style device that goes on the top, or even a sub tank at 0.21 ohms, yeah. Because it's got the circuitry built into the battery, which will allow you to use a low resistance device on the top safely. But when I tried it on the EMAO, it didn't like it. I also tried it on the EVIC Supreme with the top off, and didn't like it on there either. So that's quite good. So what can I tell you about it? What more can I tell you about it, really? Well, it's nice. That's all there is to say. It produces, and that's what you want. There's no ifs, no buts. It's charged up, and it produces a nice lot of vapor. Let me get rid of it for you. It's a little bit loud with the window open, but it clears the vapor quite quickly. Because it creates a reverse vortex, don't you know, when you open the window. The pressure differential between the outside and the inside sucks it out. Did you know that? Yeah, fun fact. So, let me give you a kind of comparison between a 10 second lung inhale on the Vaper, and then following that, I'll do a 10 second lung inhale using the Limo 2, which is coiled up at 0.17 with Ni200 and Japanese cotton, set at 500 degrees Fahrenheit and 25 watts on the Vapor Shark. So first things first, 10 second lung inhale using the Vaper. produces, doesn't it? It certainly produces. Let me just get rid of the vapor again. There we go. And now we'll do the same thing, but with the Limo 2. And I have to say, this is 18 milligram juice I've got in here. I'm hardcoring it today. As you can see, plenty of vapor from that as well. It's comparable with the Limo 2, with a bigger device, even though it's such a small battery and such a small tank, it likes to suck the juice, I have to say. And it doesn't get as hot as the Blaze, I have to say. They do recommend that you don't chain. Wow, an Aston Martin DB7 just shot past me. And it was nice, I've got to say. Yes, Atom do recommend that you don't inhale and then do another one really quickly, because it will get warm. What they recommend is 30 seconds in between, which is, you know, not bad. But if you're doing a decent lung inhale, you don't need to do another one within 30 seconds, to be fair. And it also depends on the strength of juice you're using. Now, I've got the juice that I got from Herman Vapes, which is the strawberry smoothie, but that's only 6 milligram. So that's not too bad when you're doing the old lung inhales. On the Limo 2, I've got some juice from Icelix, which is the Piccadilly I've got in here, 18 milligram. Very nice juice, I have to say. But obviously, I wouldn't do as many lung inhales in one go using 18 milligram, because I'd feel a little bit nicked out after a while. So 6 is really good for sub-ohming, I have to say. Although I've been using a lot of 3 as well on the various devices. I do have on the VT60, which is here, the Tornado tank, with a wicked coil that I did myself using the re-wicking, the rebuildable version of the CL. That's a 0.17 using NI200 and Rayon I've got in that one, and that's going rather nicely. But in there I've got some Elements Orange Burst, which is rather nice, I have to say. But the strawberry smoothie, it's okay. I would vape it occasionally, but it wouldn't be an everyday, an all-day vape. It does have a nice taste of strawberry, but you know, you win some, you lose some with the juices. Some of them you like, some of them you don't like. So I'll try anything once, apart from bacon or chicken pie. Or crab juice, or stuff like that, or stinky shark, or blue cheese. Although I do like blue cheese, but I don't think I'd like a blue cheese vape. Anyway, back to the Vaper. It does whistle a little bit, and I've got that kind of 3/4 open. If I open it all the way on the airflow. And don't forget, on the atomizer, I've got the atomizer set at full juice flow, which is the best, really. So have it all open. So this is the airflow fully open. And as you can see, it fair produces. So yeah, that's the Atom Vaper. It's rather nice. It's a nice little form factor. It's kind of top pocketable, although it does stick out a little bit. If you've got it in your pocket, in your trouser pocket, be careful when you get in the car, because I've snapped them before. Not this one, but I've snapped other ones before when I've got into the car, snapped off the end.
But there you go. Right, I'm going to carry on with my journey, and hopefully I can get finished relatively quickly and then head back home again. So maybe a bit of a long day, 9 hours driving and maybe 3 hours of working. Still, it's a long Sunday, but there you go. I will see you back in the studio anyway. Tatty bye. And there you go, I unmuted myself again. Yes, now I did mention the Elements juice, and I got it wrong, it's Fresh Squeeze. That's the orange one, Fresh Squeeze. I've got it here, it's very tasty. Angela, don't worry about making a video while you're driving. Top Gear have been doing it for years. It's a fixed camera, and it's right, so I can see everything that's going on. I can see everything around me. You don't see my eyes with my sunglasses on. Always looking. Front, back, ring mirrors, back mirror, everything. Yes, it's all good. Marco driving in a haze, says Bernice. Yes, which is why you use the old negative vortex thing and it sucks all the vapour out of the car, which is good. It is very good indeed. Now, I've got another little bit to show you, and we're going to go slightly over because I started late. And Paul is going. See you later, Paul. I know it's gone past 10 o'clock. I've got one little bit of VT left, and this I've had this in the pipeline for a few weeks. But it's a Tube Tank Pro. Yes. Have a little look, and then I'll talk to you at the end.
Here's the second little thing that I was going to show you from e-cig Expo, and this is the Tube Tank Pro from Volcano. This is a stainless steel and Pyrex atomizer tank, and I also picked up some of these, which are NI coils, so you can use it as a temperature controlled device on a DNA 40 chipset. So let's have a little look at what we get in the box. Nice boxes. Seen nice boxes with this kit these days. Some lovely do not eat silica. There is your tank itself, and then you get an instruction manual, a spare set of O-rings, always handy, a spare Pyrex tank, and two spare atomizers. Does all that come out? Yes, it does. Let me pull it all out for you. So here you are. You have a fully assembled Tube Tank Pro. You get two extra atomizer heads. There's already one in the device, and you get a replacement Pyrex tank should you break it. So very handy. Very much in line with the sub-tank way of doing things, and also the Limo 2 way of doing things. So a lot of the tanks now are coming in thick and fast, but they're coming ready assembled with all the spares that you need. Including O-rings. This doesn't come with a screwdriver set, but you don't need that because it's not an RBA. It's an atomizer one. So let's get those out of the way and we'll look at the device itself. So here it is. It's got a lovely weight to it. It's quite heavy. It's a wide bore tip on the top, as you can see there, tapers in the middle. Removable, so you can, if you want to, put another 510 style tip on top. This is a Gary Dibley. Stainless steel tip, doesn't really go with the tank, that one, but it fits. So we'll put the original one back in. And it's got two O-rings, which is good, nice and secure. Airflow on the bottom, so you can change the airflow depending on your tastes. And to change it around and fill it, you unscrew the bottom section, and there you go. You have your atomizer head, which just screws out and falls over. So it's a strange design actually on the bottom. Let me just zoom in for you and you'll see if I can get it to focus. Yes, Very strange design on the bottom, these four little pins. Quite chunky. I've no idea whether that's rebuildable or not. I suspect it could be, but I'm not going to muck about with these so far. This is a 0.5 ohm coil, and this is not for temperature control. This is just a normal coil in there. So what we're going to do is we're going to put a temperature control coil in for use on the DNA40s. I'll just open it up. And this this pack is a pack of five replacement heads, which I got from Volcano as well. So we'll pop one of those out. And it's simply a case of screwing it into the base, thus, and there we go. It's hand tight, not too tight. And what I'll do is I'll just take the tank I have on the DNA 40 off, and I will put this on for you, and we'll see what the resistance is. Now, according to the actual head, says it is 0.25 ohms. And the DNA 40 on the RDNA 40 says it's 0.27, so it's kind of 0.02 out. But that's okay, I can live with that. So there you go, we'll just take that off for the moment and we'll put some juice in this. It's a shame that more tanks aren't doing what the Limo 2 has done. In my opinion, while I'm on this subject, and that is having a fill at the top. The actual filling mechanism on the Limo 2 for me is fantastic, and it doesn't, mine has not leaked at all. I've had no issues with mine at all, apart from the bottom section came away, but Liberty Flights, who I got the Limo 2 off, replaced that with absolutely no question whatsoever. I sent them an email the next day. I had the new device, so all power to Liberty Flights while I'm talking about that. Anyway, back to the Tube Tank Pro. You can see that it's quite wide at the bottom section where the atomizer fits in. It's quite a wide atomizer head, and that fits in the little slot. So we'll just fill it up. And what I've got is some Wolfester, which I got from Namba Juice at e-cig Expo. It's a lovely blue colour, isn't it? I'm just going to prime the coil with some of that, and also just on the outside of the wicking, just to make sure we've got plenty of juice on there. This is a PGVG mix, and we're just going to fill this up. Squirty, squirty, squirty. It's got about a 4-5 mil, I think, capacity, this tank. I'm just going to put that much in for now. And put the bottom section on. Careful not to cross-thread it. I've done that before with tanks. Ended up in all sorts of hassle. I'm leaving the airflow fully open. And we'll put this on the RDNA 40. On the Vapor Shark. Leave that for a second while I put the top on my juice. And that should have soaked in by now. Still getting resistance of 0.26. It's 0.26 now, not 0.27. I've got this set at 400 degrees Fahrenheit, and it's set currently at 20 watts. Yes, with half a battery. I'm going through batteries a lot more these days. Now I've started sub-ohming and pumping the old wattage up, I've got to say. It's all good stuff though. So we'll give this a little bit of a toke and see what happens. And you can see there, produces quite nicely. I'm going to be using this tank over the next couple of days, so I can give you more information on it on Tuesday. And this is actually going to go on another device, which I will be showing you soon. No more details are available. Just keep watching the show, because I've got a lovely new device to show you, which this fits on rather nicely. So for me and from the Tube Tank Pro. It's back to the studio.
And we are back to the studio. Hello. And I have it on this device here. Now, I filmed that about, 4 weeks ago, something like that. So I've been using this, but it's had another coil in it. I've been using it for the same amount of time, about 4 weeks. And it's rather nice, I have to say. And I would give you a huge plume, but it will make me disappear, so I won't. But you saw on that bit of VT there what it can kick out. It's a very nice tank, nicely built, very heavy. But like I said in that bit of VT, it's a shame that more aren't doing this top fill bit like the Limo 2, because that for me is perfect. I'd have to take it off and then screw the bottom and take the drip tip off and stand it up and fill it up and tip the bottle over, which I've done before, if it's one that's got the old dropper. But there you go. So yes, Tube Tank Pro from Volcano. Now there is another device that I will be showing you hopefully in the next few weeks. Still waiting for it to arrive. So more about that in the future. It's nearly time for a Vape Fest as well. So we'll have a little bit of a Vape Fest on next week's show. We'll be looking forward to the weekend after this, because it's going to be 3 days of goodness. Someone in chat mentioned, I think Spiritus mentioned about the B2B, and that's on a Friday. So it's Saturday and Sunday, which is the public days with the live music, etc. So I'm looking forward to that big time. I hope the weather holds out for us this year as well. Anyway, that is about it for me tonight. I'm a little bit over time, but then I did start late. Apologies for that. We will see you, or I will see you, on next week's show, which is Tuesday. But tomorrow night, Matt has got some more DNA 200 stuff for you, looking more into the software, I believe. So whether that's Matt at 9 o'clock tomorrow night for the cave, keep an eye out on our Facebook and Twitter feeds for what's coming up, possibly on Monday. I will be here next Tuesday for next week's show. Yes, so thank you so much for tuning in. I will see you soon. And don't forget, you've also got RY4 Radio. Yes, ry4radio.com. Yay. Tatty bye.
Vaper Scene is proudly sponsored by Health E-Vape, UK purveyor of e-cigarettes and Pure Perfection e-liquid.